Hello and welcome to Bobbin Top. In this video, you will learn how to do sequins as top stitching in CLO3D.
This is the dress that I want to work with and the one that I want to add the sequins to. So in order to create the sequins, I will have to make it in Photoshop first. So let's go to Photoshop, open up the app and start up a new file. I would make the file width and height pretty much the size of the sequins. If you do want to leave a little bit of space around the sequins when you're arranging them, you want to make the canvas then a tiny bit bigger. So let's say I want mine to be 0.25, but I want to leave a tiny bit of space. If you don't leave space, that's totally fine, but then the sequins are going to be touching. So keeping that in mind, I'm going to make mine 0.3 by 0.3. I'm thinking my sequins maybe around 1/4 inch. So that's in inches. Keeping the resolution at 300. That's pretty high, probably the highest you should go. And I'm going to leave the background to be transparent. So that will make my life a little bit easier later. Create. And that is pretty tiny. So I'm going to enlarge this quite a bit. For the shape of my sequins, I would like to make a circle. So I'm going to come and grab the ellipse tool. I'm going to hold the shift and I'm going to start from top left and kind of create my circle. And that looks perfectly fine. It is just a little bit inside of the overall square. See here, I'm leaving a tiny bit of space. Hold the shift if you're going to change the shape in any way. And that looks pretty good to me. And I'm going to click return. My shape is ready. Now, if you would like this to be a particular color, you're set on your color, you can add the color here. I don't recommend that. If you make a dark color, very bright blue or dark gray or anything like that, then you would not be able to get a clear and nice change of color in CLO. Unless you want to do some kind of a gradient here, maybe some kind of a very light gradient and then overlay color. So I'm going to keep it as it is, white for now, and I'm going to just save that. I'm going to save it on my computer, and you should have a designated place. For now, I am going to save this on my desktop just for the purposes of this demo. And I'm going to call this sequence one, and I'm going to choose a PNG file that's going to preserve the transparency of the background. So make sure that you're well organized, and maybe you create a folder in where you have all of your CLO assets and just place that there. Click save. I'm going to keep it large file. And now my sequence is ready. Again, this can be a more complex shape, something a lot more interesting than what I just created. You can have a border around it, whatever you like. We're going to go to CLO. And in CLO, I will create a new top stitching. Make sure that here you're in top stitching. If there's something that you don't need, you can delete it. I will add new top stitch, and I'm going to call that top stitching sequence. Oops, sorry, in the top stitch. You can also come down here under name, if I can find that right now, right here under property editor. You can click on that and you can name that sequence one. I would suggest that whatever you name your file in Photoshop, I would suggest the same name here. You see that I changed the name here, and it also changed right here. So we are good with the name. Now going down to type, object makes whatever a button or a sequence or anything else you're adding or top stitching, it would make it really three-dimensional, but it also is a really huge file and it takes a lot of processing power. So I wouldn't choose that. I would actually choose texture and let it synchronize. Then we can go down, these we can, once we bring in the sequence, then we can deal with those. Stitches per inch, I'm gonna bring this to I'm gonna bring this to 4 because I know that mine was 1/4 inch, so I want these to be 4. And we'll see what it looks like after we bring the sequence. So come down here under material, You can already go here and change this to metal or plastic, whatever you would like that sequence to be. I'm going to go for metal. It says render only, so I might not be able to see it really well. Now, the most important thing is right here under basic parameters. If it's closed, make sure that you click to open it. Take a look at the texture. Right now, the texture is a stitch with a thread. You can clearly see the thread here. This is where we will bring our sequence. So just click on it or on the four squares next to it. Click on the four squares next to it and come to wherever you saved your sequence. Mine is on the desktop right now. It is called Sequins. And you can see that the shape appears. Just click open and that shape is now there. Now, if you would like to add more texture, you can add a normal map that you can also create in Photoshop. And I have another video you can check out on how to create normal map. In terms of color, this is where it gets really interesting. Come to color, click on it, and choose the color that you would love your sequence to be. So let's choose something fun and bright. I'm gonna go for a really bright orange. We will see that nicely on our dress. I'm trying to move this so I can see the dress and the color. So maybe a really bright reddish orange. I'd love that. I'm gonna click OK. And that's going to be the color of my sequins. Now, in order to, you can also take a look at the metalness, the reflection, configuration. You can take a look at these later, but let's get our sequins on the dress and see how much we love that. So we would need to, let's open up the 2D window. Let's actually open up both so that we can see our tools. Now, let's go to Topstitch, and we need to see where we're going to apply that sequence at Topstitch. Right now, I have no indication of how and where I can place the sequence. So the way we can do that is through our internal lines. So wherever you would like to place the sequence, keep in mind that is Topstitching. We're just overlaying a sequence on top of it instead of stitch lines. So we do need to create internal lines. And let's go to internal polygon line, shortcut G. So you can just click G on your keyboard. And now we have our lines. So let's go into the 2D window. That's what I did. Now you can create freeform lines if you like, for example. So let's say that I wanna create kind of a freeform shape here. Actually, let's do that on the skirt. It might be more interesting. So let's let's see if I can create a line. You can hold the shift and create some kind of a curvy lines, whatever you like. Or you can also, so, oh, gorgeous lines. So when you finish, you can click return. Or you can also come to the internal rectangle or ellipse or create some kind of shape that starts with what you already have here. So let's go for the ellipse and let's place a couple of those. Let's go on the skirt. So let's say I have a couple of those. You can hold the shift to make perfect circles or you can create something that is more asymmetric. And my gorgeous designs are coming to life and they're absolutely asymmetric, but hey, they would look amazing. You can also copy the lines of your contour, let's say of the neckline, and just offset those. So just come to edit pattern, select that tool, select the line that you want to offset, right click on it and offset as internal line. And then you got to choose the distance. So let's say we'll place 0.5, for example. So that's, whoa, it went all the way down. So that is not what we want. So I'm going to select both lines. That would be much more favorable. Offset is internal line. Let's choose again the 0.5. Click OK. Yes, that looks much better. And it's perfectly symmetric. It's none of that riffraff that I did here. But now we're ready to apply the top stitch. So let's come and select one of our top stitch lines, not the edit top stitch. I want to do the, I can't even see them here. So let's go for the free form, free top stitch. Okay, let's select that, and we can now go across the lines where we want to apply the top stitch. Select that, and you can't see anything. Or you can barely see my top stitch. There you go. Here is our top stitch. I'm going to click away. Whoop. Did we lose it? No, we didn't. It's right here. It's in our 3D window. It magically appeared perfectly aligned on that internal line. And if you missed what happened, let's do it again. So I actually want to open both the 2D and the 3D window. Look at that beautiful sequence that we got here. It's perfectly placed. And if I zoom in, you can see that there's a little bit of space in between the sequins, and that's what I meant. This one's a little messed up, but we can adjust that. You can. That's what I meant when I was saying that if you have a little bit of space, that's where it will show up. If you didn't do that, they will be touching each other or touching sequins to sequins. Let's open up. If you lose your property editor and you don't see them, just come down here to the bottom right, click on that, and that will restore all of your windows. So, but it will, I want to close the library. I would like that space there. And now we did create those internal lines on the skirt, right? Those gorgeous lines that are out of control. So let's apply some of that sequence. If you don't see the sequence here, that means that you're not on top stitch. Just click on top stitch and click on any of these lines. You can also work with a segment, but it will only work on segment by segment. So for example, it will only go from point to point. So if I select, let's say one in the middle, see how the top stitch appeared here and the same here, right? So as soon as I click, because I'm selected in this sequence, then that's what it's applying. Now you could also add another sequence and go through the same process, but just give it a different color. So I'm gonna go back to my desktop, select the sequence, open it up. That's my, I'm not sure why this is not renaming. There you go. Double left click on it and it will go in there. So I'm gonna call that sequence two. And you can also say, let's say blue to make it even clearer which one is which. So now I'm going to come down, make sure that you select it here, come down to the property editor, and where is this thing going? Stop. Click on the color. Click on the color that you would like to select. Click OK. And now this sequence will be blue. So let's say if I'm going to select all of these lines, and I need to apply the top stitch there. So let's go to the top stitch. Make sure that this is actually the right texture. Oh, I see what's happening. So let's make this texture. And also let's go to take a look at this. Stitches per inch is 14. What does that mean? That we have 14 stitches per inch. We don't want 14. We want no more than 2, 3, or 4. Otherwise, you're going to get some giant, you're going to get a 14 sequence of 14 stitches per inch. And here, for some reason, our texture, let's go to the texture and bring the sequence again. Not sure why that didn't stick in there. Click open, add it on, and there we go. Now we have our sequence. Offset is 16. I'm going to make that 0 because I want it to be directly on the line, not offset off of the line. And see, now it's much better. Okay, so the offset was off, and now I've aligned it to be perfectly on the line, and now we're good to go. Again, you can go through the same process, add a different sequence, and if you select a particular line, let's say this one, you can apply the blue or you can apply the red, either one. And you can see that everything is changing here. And you can have as many as you would like. This one is selected in the blue sequence. And you can keep going until you're happy and satisfied with your design. I am very happy with what I have right now. I'm going to go to the red one and apply the red one to this gorgeous, beautiful, curvy line that is out of this world. and our design is almost complete. And again, you can create whatever freeform lines, you can choose shapes, whatever you like. So let's bask in the glory of our beautiful design. Here is our, well, only on the front, here is our beautiful sequins as top stitching on our yellow dress. If you like what you saw, if you learned something, please subscribe to Bobbin Talk. There'll be much more. There'll be many more videos. Thank you so much. Enjoy.